第三个呢，就是讲这个诸法无啊，因为我们前面讲呢，一切都是无常的，那么无常的原因呢 是痛苦的，那谁痛苦呢？就是我痛苦，但是我在那里呢，我们要去照，如果我们没有去观察的时候呢，人人都说我就是我啊，就是有什么不知道的，每个人都在寻求，但 这就是我们大家人们普通的概念。但如果真正去照我的时候呢，很难照到。佛教里面，有一个叫拉仙比丘，他跟一个国王呢，就是有一个对话。国王说是我是肯定存在的，然后拉仙比丘说，你到底在哪里？你的手是你呢？你的头还是你呢？你的这个脚啊，整个身体啊，皮肤啊，以及整个里里外外的事，你一个一个分出来，就是到底是哪一个是你的？所谓的我，后来他一个一个分析呢，确实也是照不出来，就是我的手呢，就是也不单单是我。后来他说，我是整个身体的综合，但我的身体的综合的话，那你如果每一个身体的部分分开的时候照不到我呢，那综合当中到底在哪里？所以这是我们这个最后的话，就是这个过往呢，就是确实也是所谓的我只是一个概念和只是一个执着。真正去寻找的时候他也找不到啊，是这个找不到的。所以这是一种我们说诸法无我，也就是说诸法都是空性的，但是每个人的是就本来虚伪的东西呢，就执着为，就是这是我们每一个凡夫人的一种执着。其实这是用科学来观察也是确实，包括爱因斯坦和牛顿，就是今天就让他来就是照的话呢，就是他也会照不到的，就是只不过这个爱因斯坦和牛顿呢没有这个上过我的这个般若空性的课，就是我经常觉得有点可惜，如果他们上的话呢，他们肯定会至少也是通到一部分的这种这个我的这个道理，这样的话呢他们死的时候也不会那么痛苦。
So the third one is an phenomenon is emptiness or stepless.And so we talk about impermanence bring us suffering. And then we will ask, who is suffering? And we will say, I am suffering. But if you go to look at or look for this self, you will say, how should I look for the self? I am I, here. But if you really look at this, you will find out this self is just a concept. Mm. It's our habitual thinking.Because there was a story in Buddhist Sutra, a bhikkhu, his name is Nashan, and he asked the king, or the king asked him, where is this I or self? And he said, here, it exists here, I am I. And then the king pointed to him and said, so is your hand you, or your skin, or your feet?If you look at the inside and outside, which part of you is you? And then he look at himself and find out, oh, my head is not me, my foot is not me. Maybe the aggregation of all parts are me. And then the king said, if you cannot find you in any part of your body, how can you see there is a you of the collection of every part?Then you find out, oh, this self is really is just a concept. It's just a capture thinking from our mind. If you really go to look for it, you cannot find it out. So when we say all phenomena is selfless, it's about emptiness. And we all cling or have this kind of attachment, although everything is illusory, but we think they are all intrinsically existent. But that is not true.If Einstein and Newton, if they get a chance to look for the self, they may not be able to find out the self. And Khenpo said, I think it's a shame or it's a pity that they didn't take the course on selflessness or emptiness. If they did, maybe they will not be so suffering when they were dying.
这样的这种我的空性法门呢，其实我们不管是你是什么身份的人都去 先学习，然后去自己观修，最后真的，我们每个人的每天都是可能很执着的我，还有我的东西啊，我的房子啊，我的车啊，我的家属啊，等等等，就是我和我所呢，每个人的从到早到晚都去寻找的。但如果我们用另一种方式来，用佛教的这种所谓的中观思想、般若思想，那这个观点来去寻找的时候呢，这不是一种穿梭，这不是一种谣言，这是的的确确每个人去用自己的智慧去观察，他不仅仅是需要一种信仰，应该是用自己的智慧去观察的时候呢，最后所谓的我呢，除了一个假象以外，就是根本找不到。那个时候，你可能确实生活就非常非常有意义的。所以呢，我也劝大家，多学一些中观的这个，比如说，这个龙门菩萨的中观根本慧论啊，还有一些般若经的这个空心思想啊。那这样的话呢，我们就虽然需要我们同样的生活啊，就是你需要工作啊、上班啊，还要做什么事情的是同样做，就不能懈怠，就是也要做。但是在做的过程当中，遇到困难的时候呢，不像以前那样那么的脆弱，那么的这种敏感。就是我们有些人痛苦呢，敏感导致的；有些人的痛苦呢，脆弱而导致的；有些人的痛苦呢，因为你的欲望太大了而导致的。所以很多痛苦呢，我们不应该的，就是尤其很多痛苦是我们自己造成的。所以我在想，如果我们就学到一些空心法门的话呢，很多痛苦就至少会减少的。
No matter what kind of identity you have, no matter what kind of background you have, we should first study the theories and then meditate on that. If we do this practice and we study on that, we will find out that our self-attachment, our attachment toward our or my car, my house, my lover, all those things will be weakened. And if we use wisdom, not just by our belief,use wisdom, rational wisdom, to analyze all the phenomena through the approaches in Prajnaparamita and also the middle way. We will find all these things appear in a way, but the truth or the fundamental nature of it is emptiness, is selfless. And then we can live in a way much real, it's more real or realer and more meaningful.So I suggest you to study the fundamental wisdom of the middle way by Nagarjuna and also the sutras on Prajnaparamita. And if we do this, study that, and meditate on this, our life will go as normal as before. Our job can be as normally engaged in as we did before. However, you will not be so as sensitive as before. You will not be as fragile as before.Your suffering will not be as strong as before, and your desire will not be as strong as before. Then your suffering will be weakened. And then you will realize a lot of suffering that we are experiencing right now are kind of made by ourselves because of our self-attachment. So study on emptiness, then our suffering will be decreased.